this is how I've been going today all day. I have a headache, and that's today's topic. Hi everyone, I am Ilze B. I am a Latvian and I teach Latvian to English speakers. And today I'm going to teach you how to talk about headache and feeling unwell in Latvian. Since I do have a headache, I will be hiding behind the screen and I will be showing you pictures of other people. Therefore, I will be talking in the third person. I will be talking about her and him. But I will also teach you how to say that you have a headache, namely how to say a sentence that translates as "I have a headache." But let me hide behind the screen and let's start the lesson.
Let's start. And here are the two our today's new sentences that contain the four new words that we are going to discuss today. Viņa nejūtas labi. Viņai sāp galva. I'll say it again. Viņa nejūtas labi. Viņai sāp galva. So let's read that rhythm together so that you acquire that feel for how long the sentences will be. Let's start. Yes, no, yes, no, no, yes, no. Yes, no, no, yes, no. Yes, no, yes, no, no, yes, no. Yes, no, no, yes, no. Please do it without me, at least once, because I know it works, although you might think that it is pointless. No, it is not. And I thank you for that. Now let's start learning the words. Let's start from the second sentence. And the second sentence was, Viņai sāp galva. And you already know the last word. It is galva. Galva means head. Galva. I taught you this word before when I taught you the sentence, Es protu stāvēt uz galvas. Today the word is in its default form. And we need to learn the word that precedes the word galva. That word is sāp. Sāp. It's a single syllable word. Sāp. And it has the long vowel a in it. I'll repeat it again. Sāp. Sāp means hurts. So this is a very important word to learn in case of emergency if you need to speak in Latvian. And our sentence altogether was Viņai sāp galva. Viņai sāp galva. So the word that precedes the word sāp is Viņai. Viņai sāp galva. And we use this word when we talk about females. Viņai. 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 Viņai sāp galva. We would say Viņam sāp galva if a man had a headache. Viņam sāp galva. The word that precedes the word sāp then is Viņam. 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 Viņam sāp galva. But if I wanted to say that I have a headache, the first word of this same sentence would be man. Man. Man sāp galva. Man sāp galva. Man. You know this word already. But the sentence that we are practicing today is Viņai sāp galva. That sentence is about a female, third person, her. Viņai sāp galva. And remember that the rhythm was yes, no, no, yes, no. Viņai sāp galva. Yes, no, no, yes, no. Viņai sāp galva. The last word is galva. The word that precedes is sāp. They both together are sāp galva. Sāp galva. and all sentence together. The first word is viņai. Viņai. Let's say it together twice. Viņai. Viņai. And the entire sentence is viņai sāp galva. Viņai sāp galva.
All right, and I couldn't sit behind the screen. I wanted to jump in order to help you to practice pronouncing this sentence. Viņai sāp galva. I'll pronounce it one more time and then let's read it together twice. Viņai sāp galva. Let's read it together now. Viņai sāp galva. And one more time. Viņai sāp galva. And now I'll read it in the pace that's normal for a native Latvian speaker. Viņai sāp galva. I'll do it again. Viņai sāp galva. Can we do it together in that pace? Try. Let's do it twice again. Viņai sāp galva. Viņai sāp galva. Excellent. And now we can jump to the sentence number one.
So far we have learned only two words, but we have to learn four words today. The other two words are in the other sentence. That sentence was Viņa nejūtas labi. I'll pronounce it again. Viņa nejūtas labi. The last word of this sentence is labi. Labi. I believe that you have heard this word before if you have learned any Latvian at all before. So this is the word that we use to answer a question like how are you? And usually we answer labi, which means well. And I have that word on your screens now. I think that we can practice reading it together three times and then switch to the word that precedes the word labi. So let's read the word. Labi. 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 And the rhythm is yes, no. But the rhythm of the preceding word is yes, no, no. So the word itself is nejūtas. 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 Let's try to say it together. Nejūtas. Nejūtas. One more time. Nejūtas. And do you think that we can say the last two words together? That would sound like this. Nejūtas labi. I'll pronounce it again. Nejūtas labi. Let's read them together three times. Nejūtas labi. Nejūtas labi. Nejūtas labi. Excellent. And if we add the word viņa in front of these two words, we get the second sentence. Viņa nejūtas labi. Viņa nejūtas labi.
And like before, I couldn't sit behind the screen because I wanted to help you to practice pronouncing this sentence. I'll pronounce it twice and then I'd like you to read it together with me twice. Viņa nejūtas labi. Viņa nejūtas labi. Let's do it together. Viņa nejūtas labi. Viņa nejūtas labi. Very well. Please do it without me. And now I'll do it in a pace that's normal for a native Latvian speaker. After that, I'd like you to do it together with me twice again. So, it's my turn. I'm going to say twice. Viņa nejūtas labi. Viņa nejūtas labi. Let's try doing it all together. Viņa nejūtas labi. Viņa nejūtas labi. Excellent.
Today we practiced saying two sentences. Viņa nejūtas labi and viņai sāp galva. You learned four new words. Viņa nejūtas labi and sāp. The word viņai is one of the forms of the word viņa. You also learn to say viņam sāp galva. You use this for men or boys. The default form of viņam is viņš. You also learned two action words, nejūtas and sāp. The default form of the word nejūtas is nejusties, and the default form of the word sāp is sāpēt.
And that's it from me today. Tomorrow I'll be back with more good stuff. Keep up the good work and don't forget to download the PDF file where I summarize all the information that I'm giving to you in my lessons. Bye till tomorrow.